Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success, an online free educational institute. So we are continuing with the chemistry series and today we will be discussing on stereochemistry. This is the part 1 video of stereochemistry. We will be uploading more videos on stereochemistry. So if you are going into the main discussion, let me tell you about the utility of this video. So the chemistry videos which we are making would be helpful for WBJE, JE mains and JE advanced aspirants. And not only that, our target is to guide WBCS main aspirants also. The people who have taken optional subject chemistry, these videos are meant for them also. So kindly subscribe to our channel so that you can get updates whenever we upload more videos on chemistry. So there, here is something about myself. I'm Shishchandu Mitto, research scholar of Indian Institute of Technology Guwahati, and I'm running this Pioneer of Success. And I have completed BSc from University of Calcutta, BTech from chemical engineering from the same university, and now I'm doing research. So now let me go to the main topic, that is your stereochemistry section. So here basically we'll be talking about RS nomenclature. So that you keep in your mind. In this video we will only be talking about RS nomenclature. Now what is RS nomenclature, I'll be telling you. But one question you should ask yourself whenever you are studying stereochemistry, and based on the questions and their answers, you'll be deciding whether the molecule, what type of molecules are they. So the first question you should ask, if you have more than one molecules and if you think that those are stereoisomers. First question is, how many stereo centers are there? Now what is stereo center? Stereo center means, suppose you have a carbon molecule. So this carbon molecule, it has four hands. Clear? So roughly I have drawn, you can say this is the carbon molecule. So those two are in plane of this computer. And this is above the plane and this is below the plane. Now say there are four ligands A, B, C, D. Now if A not equal to B, not equal to C, not equal to D. If this is the condition, that means it has four different groups connected to this carbon. This carbon is called chiral carbon or stereocenter. So I guess this thing is clear to you now. So the first question is, how many stereo centers? If the question answer is 1, then the molecule is obviously chiral. If it has only one stereo center, then obviously the molecule is chiral. Then the next question you should ask, the question is, how many stereo centers? If the answer is 0, it has 0 stereo center, then you need to ask yourself one more question, whether they have any mirror plane or not. Now what is mirror plane? Suppose I have one letter, say A. Now it has a plane of symmetry. If I cut like this, both the side I have same nature. So it has a plane of mirror plane. So like that in molecule also you have mirror, you find mirror planes. Yeah, and so you ask yourself whether it has any mirror plane or not. If the answer is yes, then the molecule is achiral. That means if it has a mirror plane, then there is some symmetry. If symmetry present, then it is achiral. If the answer is no, that is there is no mirror plane, then you should ask yourself one more question. Are they non-identical mirror image? If those are non-identical mirror image, if the answer is yes, then obviously the molecule is chiral. If the answer is no, then again the molecule is achiral. So this way you need to ask questions, and from the answers you need to come to the point whether the molecule is chiral or not. Now if the answer of this question, how many stereoisomers, is 2 or more, then you need to ask again the same question, is there any mirror plane? If yes, whenever symmetry comes, the molecule is achiral. I have also mentioned here. So if any symmetry comes at any point of time, then it is achiral, obviously. Next question, they have non-identical mirror image. If the answer is yes, then it is Kyle. If they have non-identical mirror image, if the answer is no, they have more than two stereo centers, that means individually they are chiral, but still if they have a mirror image, then the symmetry comes, then the molecule becomes meso. That means individually, I'll be discussing it later on, individually the molecules are chiral. That means there is, suppose, a carbon C1 and C2, maybe C1 and C2 individually chiral. But if there is a mirror plane between this C1 and C2, then the molecule becomes meso, and meso combined is achiral molecule. So all these things we will be discussing in detail in the later part of this video, not this video, we will discuss it in a later video. So now let us go to, we will be discussing few definitions, that is, what is stereochemistry. Stereochemistry, as I have already mentioned, is the study of special characteristics of molecules. That means the, how the ligands, how the hands are oriented in three-dimensional space, and if they give rise to different molecules, then those are called stereoisomers, and the chemistry related to stereoisomers is called stereochemistry. Now, what is stereocenter? I have already mentioned the atom bonded to four different groups, that is stereocenter or chiral center, whatever you say. Then internal mirror plane. Suppose you have a, I have already mentioned one example, that is, if it is A, then along this we have a mirror plane. That means the plane which is dividing into two similar halves, that is called your mirror plane. Again, what is chiral molecule, optical activity, that is processing a non-identical mirror image or enantiomer. We will discuss in detail what is enantiomer. Then achiral molecule, that is superimposable on its mirror image. If I have molecule, we have an mirror image of it. If both of these two images are superimposable, then that is called achiral molecules. And now we have enantiomers. Enantiomers are non-identical mirror images, and RS is nothing but two enantiomers. We will be discussing in details in the later part of this video. Now we come to diastereomers, stereoisomers that are not enantiomers. Any two stereoisomers which is not mutually enantiomers, those are called diastereomers. Now meso compound, I have already discussed. Suppose I have two carbon atoms, C1 and C2. They are individually chiral, but there is a plane of symmetry. Then this molecule is called meso molecule, and the meso is achiral. So now we proceed to the nomenclature. There is one nomenclature RS in the stereochemistry, and its rule is called CIP rule, based on three scientists, that is Kahn, Ingold and Prelog. So this is called CIP rules. Now in stereochemistry, we have different kinds of representation of carbon molecules. So here we will represent in flying wedge. What is flying wedge? This representation is called flying wedge. Carbon, this is basically sp3 carbon, and you know this angle is near about 109 degree 28 minute. So this is the tetrahedral orientation of carbon sp3 atom, and this formula is called flying wedge formula, flying wedge representation. Now in flying wedge, what you need to know, these two in the normal line represent actually ligands, that is 1 and 2 are on the plane of the computer, and this dashed line represent, this is below the plane, and the solid line, that is 3, represents above the plane. So those things are clear, I guess. Now in this you have to name the ligands. That means you have to prioritize the ligands, and accordingly you have to make a rule of precedence. Okay, like 1 2 3 4, you have to do it. Now the first rule is, highest atomic number has higher priority. What does it mean? Suppose I have fluorine, bromine. So bromine would get priority 1. This is 1 2 3, because bromine has maximum atomic number. Then heavier isotopes get have priority. That means deuterium precedes over hydrogen. In a tie, move along the chain to the first point of difference. What does it mean? Suppose if there is a tie, suppose you have a CH3 and C2H5. So in this case, C2H5 would get priority 1 and CH3 priority 2. Why? Because you can see in methyl, the carbon is attached to 3 hydrogen atoms in methyl group. But in ethyl group, what happens? The first carbon is attached to 2 hydrogen atoms and then 1 methyl group. So here this another carbon comes. So what we basically did, we actually expanded the tree and we are getting carbon, but here it is hydrogen. So carbon has higher atomic number, so carbon gets precedence. That's why C2H5 has priority over CH3. So things are clear, I guess. Okay, the next, with multiple bonds, break each pi bond and duplicate the atoms at each end. What does it mean? Suppose I have a carbonyl group. So this is the carbonyl group. So this is a pi bond. So what we do? We break into 4 and we make it O within bracket, O within bracket. Say this one was hydrogen, this one was also hydrogen. So hydrogen, hydrogen. So this pi bond, C double bond, we have broken and we made the O and O. And then again follow the tree rule. That means if there is a tie, then go to the next level. And like that way you continue when until you get any difference, and that difference will determine the precedence rule. Okay, so the next point is put lowest priority group 4 in the back and view along the bond of the carbon to group 4. What does it mean? The fourth precedence group, you have to put it on the back side. That means in the dashed line. And the next rule is, draw an arrow 1, 2, 2, 2, 3. If it is clockwise, then the molecule is R. So what are the rules? You have to put the fourth priority group in the dashed line. Then say this is 1. Say this is 2, say this is 3. Now you go from 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, this is clockwise, so this is R. So I have taken few examples, I will tell you. Say this one. These are two mirror images. So you can see this is 1, 2, 3. So if we go 1, 2, 3, this is clockwise, that's why R. But here it is anti-clockwise, that's why it is S. Now I'll tell you two rules. If you switch any two bonds, that means here you can see what we did. We made exchange 1 and 2. So 2 becomes 1, 1 becomes 2 here. It was R initially, because when we go 1, 2, 3, it is clockwise, that's why R. But when we just change this 1 and 2, now you can see it is going 1, 2, 3 in anti-clockwise, that means S. So if we change any two ligands mutually, then the R becomes S, S becomes R. Again, if we change 1 and 3, so two successive changes leads to the same molecule. So initially it was R, finally it is R. Okay, so two successive changes will lead to same molecule. So that was the representation in flying wedge. The same representation in Fischer, I'll tell you, there are a few rules. At every intersection, the vertical lines are pointed back and the horizontal lines are pointed upwards. What does it mean? In flying wedge, whatever you had, I'll tell you, it was like this, na? In tetrahedral structure, the structure was like this. So this dashed line was below the plane and this solid line was above the plane. Now what we do, we little bit move it in this direction. So when we move it, then what happens? This dashed line also becomes out of plane to this computer, and this solid line also does the same thing. And the lines which were in the plane of the paper, that actually moves in the backward, that is the below beneath the plane of this computer. So like that we have to move the molecule. Once you move this molecule, then you have this thing. Okay, then you just remove this solid and dashed line and make a cross sign, plus sign, whatever you say, then it becomes a Fisher projection. So I will tell you one by way, one by one. Suppose this was the molecule. Say this was the molecule. Say this one is your solid. Say this one was 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we move in this direction. We move it such a way that this 2 and 4 comes in a plane that is above the plane of this computer. So this is 2. When you rotate this 2, this goes here, that means this becomes 2, and this backward direction, that is a dashed line, comes here, so this is becoming 4, and your 1 remains here and your 3 remains here. So the projection, if we just remove this, it is becoming 4, 2, 1, 3. Yeah, so that is the Fisher representation of this particular molecule. So these things you need to know. Now, yeah, it is also given here, I can show you. See, this was 2, now I am moving it in this direction. So 2 would come here, and this 4 would again come here, 1 will remain here, 3 will remain here. So that is the Fisher representation. Now there are two things, point 3 and point 4. This is very important. It is legal to rotate Fisher projection by 180 degree in the plane of the paper, but it is not legal to move it 90 degree. So 90 degree rotations or multiples of 90 degree rotations are not allowed, but 180 degree or multiples of 180 degree is allowed. That means you can rotate it 180 degree, you can rotate it 360 degree, you can rotate it 360 plus 180 degree, like that way. But 90 degree is not allowed. Again, one single exchange is not allowed, but two mutual exchange. Suppose I exchange 1 and 4 and 2 and 3. That will lead to same molecule, but a single exchange is not allowed. Again, you have to give the precedence, and precedence rule is based on your atomic number, as we have already discussed in the earlier part. And then you have to put this fourth molecule in the vertical line below here. Then you need to go to 1, 2 and 3. If it is clockwise, then it will give you R. If it is anti-clockwise, it will give you S. So the rules which are allowed, that is 180 degree rotation, two mutual exchange, by that way you need to put this 4 here, that is in the vertical line below. Now you go to 1, 2, 3. So it is going in which direction? Anti-clockwise. So anti-clockwise means S. If it is going in the clockwise direction, 1, 2, 3, then it is your R. So those are the things you need to know. I guess things are clear now, and I will be making more videos on RS nomenclature and stereochemistry. So please follow us on YouTube, and please subscribe to our channel, and if the videos are helping you, kindly share it on social media, and I'll be very much helpful if you share our videos on social media. Thank you very much.